So what is a confined space then? If your first thought is a fully enclosed, tight space with no room to move around, with tricky access and egress, then you're only partially right. So our space needs to be enclosed, but it doesn't have to be fully. It can be partially enclosed, something like a trench or a pit or a well. But this alone doesn't classify it as a confined space. For us to identify our fully or partially enclosed space as confined, there has to be the potential for one or more of five specified risks being present. These five foreseeable risks can be easily remembered with the acronym FHEAD. F, fire and explosion. Do we have a flammable atmosphere? H, heat. Is there a loss of consciousness potential through a rising body temperature? E, for entrapment, an entrapment in free-flowing solids. A, asphyxiation, through poisonous gases, asphyxiating gases, or a lack of oxygen. And D, drowning, through an increase in the rise of liquid in our space. So if through our risk assessment we can identify one or more of these hazards present in our space, then we have to classify it as confined. And we have to put all control measures in place possible to mitigate those risks. The outcome of those control measures will determine the risk level of our confined space.